Era una época de tradiciones. Una época de valores. Una época...
¡A la gente diferente! ¡Nos está llegando el momento!
Para agitar las cosas.
En Baltimore ni hablar.
¡Déjenme saber y nos lo estamos perdiendo!
¡Dala!
¡Holly!
¡Noreen! ¡Doreen!
And I'm... late.
The casting process for Hairspray was unusually long. It devoted the first several months to a nationwide city-by-city search for the central character, Tracy.
I had read on the internet that New Line Cinema was making a new Hairspray movie. I went in for an audition.
We saw hundreds and hundreds of girls.
12 at a time, we will bring you upstairs.
I wanted somebody who was 17 or 18, and I wanted her to be very pretty. I wanted somebody who could really sing and who could really move and somebody who enjoyed their body.
He sort of immediately had an instinct about her.
A couple of weeks later, they called and they said, you have a screen test. And I was like, oh my God, you know, okay.
They put me in full Tracy hair, makeup, and costume.
This is insane. I was never screen tested before. It's my first time, so I was geared up to go.
I am so ready. I'm ready to go so cool.
I looked at myself and I was like, oh my God, I look like Tracy Durnblad, and I love it.
I don't want to be a laundress. I want to be famous.
Nikki showed up on that soundstage as though she were born on a Hollywood soundstage. It was as natural as though it were a second skin for her.
No inhibitions. I just put all of Nikki Blonsky and what I had to offer out on the table. I was not hiding anything anymore. It was, this is me, and this is what I got, and I hope you like it.
Dancing on the show is my dream.
I called the producers and the studio, actually, and I said, I think it's gonna be this girl.
I love you, Baltimore.
And she works in an ice cream parlor. And Nikki was told that we were doing a behind the scenes in the making of Hairspray, where we were following the final four girls, and could we come to where she worked and shoot for the DVD?
I said, okay, come to Cold Stone, you know, an ice cream store, but okay.
It was cameras everywhere and microphones, and I was like, this is interesting.
And her family was there, but none of them had any idea that we were even close to a decision.
What we wanted to do was to surprise her.
I taped a message to her. They sat her down and said, here's a message from the director.
Hey, Nikki, I think that you should probably, you know, make yourself a big ice cream cone, because it's you, honey. You got the part.
I literally could not control myself.
It was really like the longest shot that we'd ever find her.
It was just magic. It was magic for her. It was magic for us.
Nikki is the Tracy for this movie.
I'm crying, but I'm standing here today because I followed my dreams, and my dreams came true.
I'm Tracy.
Oh, ya he leído sobre eso. Es un decorado falso de Hollywood.
No, señora.
¿Es que voy a creerme que está en el espacio de verdad?
No es John Glenn, señora Durnblad.
¿Por qué estamos viendo esto?
Usted observe.
Joey, Mikey,
Nikki, Becky,
Jesse,
Dala,
Holly,
Noreen,
Doreen,
Lynn. And I'm Tracy.
Oh, Dios mío.
For me, the roadmap is the music, and Mark wrote wonderful, high-energy, specific music with Scott.
The 60s were a period that we were fond of musically, and that's what really attracted us to the project.
And the thing that struck me immediately was that Mark and Scott had written an amazing score. We honor the original material, and then we reinvent it.
The score of Hairspray is just an amazing score, and, you know, recording it, we wanted to be respectful of the original score. We want it to be true to the 60s, but also be relevant to an MTV generation today. You want them to really eat it up and really enjoy listening to the soundtrack.
We were lucky that the pop vernacular of the early 60s is full of dramatic stories told in pop songs. Probably the best era to find songs that are so dramatic.
Music is the best. It's all about the music.
Recording studio, we were being barraged with these stars coming through the door, and everyone walked into every recording session fully prepared, made sure they all knew the songs and inside and out, the melody, the timing, everything. When they're up there singing and acting with the microphone, they paint such a vivid picture of what will be happening on the set. Queen Latifah is just amazing. I Know Where I've Been is such a moving song.
I get to sing, dance, and act all the time. So for me, it's a chance to sort of let it all hang out, you know, and really, you have to put yourself out there.
It was like school. We had woke up every morning, and we had periods scheduled, you know, music rehearsal, scene rehearsal, musical test, dance rehearsal, like right out of an old MGM thing, you know. And that's the magic of a musical.
Hey, Tracy, hey, baby, look at us. Where is there a team that's half as fabulous? Go, 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 the past now. Say hello to this red carpet ride.
It was so thrilling to hear John Travolta sing something Scott and I had written. Watching him also in the recording studio was the first time to really kind of see and hear him getting into the character. And that was really exciting.
If there's a song that makes me happy, it's Good Morning Baltimore. And to have practiced it for so long and then go lay down the tracks of me doing it and doing it the way that I wanted to do it and the way that this Tracy would do it was the most amazing experience.
I think my favorite number is Baltimore Crabs because I have had so much fun working with Michelle on it, and she is absolutely unbelievable. She has so much fun with it that it's been really fun to get to really watch her be so excited about a dance number.
I love being in the recording studio.
You can laugh, but life's a test. Don't do this, don't do that, remember. Mother knows best.
You just sort of lose any sense of time, and it's a lot of fun.
The finale of the show was like River Deep, Mountain High, which is You Can't Stop the Beat.
Which was Tina Turner and Phil Spector. It was Black meeting White. So the last song in the show, You Can't Stop the Beat, was certainly born of trying to recreate that same kind of synergy.
My favorite song is You Can't Stop the Beat. It's just so gorgeous.
This is a magical finale number that sums up everyone's storylines. And it's that classic musical moment that just sort of leaves you wanting more, but happy.
But what you're going to get with Hairspray is kind of like what you got with Grease. A lighthearted, deeply entertaining, feel-good musical. The numbers make it spectacular.
Para cualquiera que haya deseado algo más grande,
bailar en este programa es mi sueño.
Llega el momento de saltarse todas las reglas.
¿Quieres ser popular? Haz peñas mañana y ven a la audición.
En esta casa nadie irá a ningún concurso.
Pero mamá.
Guarda tu vida privada para las cámaras. ¡Oh! ¡Te brilla!
¡Venga, sale que se enteren!
El nuevo miembro de nuestro consejo, Tracy Thorblad.
Conocerte es el comienzo de una gran aventura.
Desde luego, Tracy ha cambiado nuestros parámetros.
Que lo digas.
Muy pronto, si sigues tu propio ritmo...
Como entren aquí más blancos, esto parecerá una urbanización.
No tiene límites lo lejos que puedes llegar.
Oh, 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 you can't stop today. As it comes speeding down the track. Child, yesterday is history. And it's
Hairspray.
Esto es América. Hay que pensar a lo grande para ser grande.
Ser grande no es un problema en esta familia, Wilbur.